Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Deep Biology. Today we will be learning about one more important ecological concept, that is environment, its special reference to its abiotic and biotic factors. So without wasting time, let's start. As we know, environment is the sum total of all biotic and abiotic factors, substance and conditions that surround and potentially influence organisms without becoming their constituent part. That means environment are the sum total of all biotic which is connected with living beings and abiotic which is connected with non-living beings, and conditions or factors that surround and potentially influence over the organisms without becoming their constituent part. Various components of environments are interlinked as well as interdependent. That means the various factors of the environment are interlinked and also they are interdependent, each one over the other, and they function at local, regional and global scale. That means the climate may be microclimate or regional climate or global climate. On the basis of some parameters, environments can be discussed into two broad aspects. One is abiotic factors and other one is biotic factors. These abiotic factors, the most predominant parameters are temperature, water, light and soils. The temperatures can influence on living organisms in several ways. The organisms cannot tolerate wide range of temperature fluctuations. It may be high or low. Those organisms or animals can tolerate wide range of temperatures. They are called euthermal animals. And those animals cannot tolerate wide range of temperature fluctuations. They are called stenothermal animal or organisms. That means with the extremes of temperatures, it may be low or high, organisms cannot live long and ultimately become dead. In the environment, we can see that some organisms cannot tolerate narrow range of temperature fluctuations. They can change their body temperature according to the environment. Those animals are known as poikilothermal or ectodermal or cold-blooded animals. Say, frog and snakes. While some animals cannot change their body temperature according to the environmental conditions up to some extent, that can regulate their internal body temperature up to certain levels. These animals are called homeothermal or endothermal or warm-blooded animals, as for example human beings. The temperatures can influence or affect on living beings in several aspects. In case of growth, it can greatly influence and also influence the metabolic activity of the organisms through controlling the enzymes activity. and also temperature can influence the reproductive activity of the animals, because the temperatures can control the gonadal development of the animals. Not only that, the temperature can also regulate the sex ratio in the animal walls. In case of Daphnia, a crustacean of arthropod family, we can see at normal temperature, Daphnia can produce only female offspring, but in fluctuating temperatures or wide variations of temperature, the Daphnia produce both male and female offsprings. And the temperature are also control the distributions of the organisms. Not only that, the temperatures are also in the influence in the colorations of the animals or plants. We can see that where temperature is high, the animals having dark color, and where temperature is low or cold, their body coloration is light in colors. The temperatures are also influencing the mating behavior of the animals and also influencing the morphology of the organisms. Next to the temperatures, water are the most influencing abiotic factors of environments. You can see that where the water scarcity or lack of water, the plant can grow at these adverse situations by changing their morphological features. Those plants are called xerophytes. Those are stay in the lack of water or scarcity of water region. And where water is abundant, in case of aquatic conditions, the plants living in the aquatic condition are called hydrophytes. We can see that in marine water or estuarine water body, where fresh water and marine water are mixed up, there these regions have high salinity, and this salinity can influence the organisms' physiology and distribution. Those organisms can tolerate a wide variations of salinity. They are called urehalines. And while those organisms does not have the ability to tolerate wide fluctuations of salinity, they are called stenohalines. And next one important abiotic factor is light. Light can directly influence the photosynthesis, which is the ultimately food chain controlling factors, and also influence the growth of the plants. Not only that, this light are directly control the transpiration of the plants by controlling opening the stomata of the leaves, and the light also influence the germination of the seeds, and also influence the pigmentation of the plant and animals, and also influence the movements. In case of nesting movements, we can easily see the influence of lights. In addition, light can directly influence the daily rhythm in animals. We can easily see in diurnal animals, they are active during the day times, and in case of nocturnal animal, they are only active in the night times, and in oral animal, they are only active in the early morning or dawn, and in desperate animals, they are active only at the
sunsets, hours, and in crepuscular animal, they only activate the dawn and sunset both. And the light are also influenced in the photoperiodism. In case of photoperiodism, it may be short day, long day, or day neutral. The light also influence the bird migrations, leaf fall, and dormancy of seeds, and also influence the animals behavioral activity. In some cases, due to short day light, the animal undergo in hibernation during winter seasons. You can easily see hibernation in case of frogs, and the light are also influence the flowering vegetations of the plants are also and also influence on animal breeding seasons. And also light influence the June of aquatic environments. Like this light can separate the aquatic environments as littoral, mimetic, aquatic orthopundal, and benthic. In case of littoral, it is shallow coastal regions. Light is able to pass through shallow water and reach the bottom. Therefore, producer occur throughout from surface to bottom. And in case of mimetic, it is open water zone where water is very deep. Amount of oxygen and light decrease with depth. Why? In case of aquatic or profundal zones, the zone of depth water below the aquatic zone and above the bottom to which light does not penetrate. The zone is therefore is perpetual or continuous remain darkness. Producers do not occur in this part. Instead, only consumers are found in the profundal or aquatic zone. And in benthic zone or benthic region, in deep lakes and seas, the bottom is also in perpetual or continuous darkness, but in shallow water, light does penetrate. And one more important abiotic factor is soil. Sometimes the soil is known as adaptive factors. The textures on the basis of soil texture, the soil may be sandy, clay, and loams. This soil can form through the process of physical weathering and chemical weathering. The soil texture can influence the animal distributions in a great way. You can easily see in case of earthworm, their distributions are regulated by the texture of the soils. And while in case of biotic factors, all organisms are under the biotic factors and all organisms are interacting themselves. Sometimes these interactions may be interspecific and sometimes their interactions may be interspecific. And sometimes this interaction may be negative and sometimes their interaction may be positive. In case of mutualism, their interaction is positive through both interacting organism can gain benefit. And in case of parasitism, we can see that the interaction is negative because one receive gain, one has loss. And in case of commensalism, one get benefit and other receives non-benefit or non clones. So there is different types of interactions we can see in the biotic factors. This is all about environmental factors with special reference to its biotic and abiotic components and how these different factors can influence the physiological activity of the living organisms. I hope that you have received some new input through this tutorial. Thank you for watching me.